Hello, everyone. Did you know that right now there are several million viruses around you and inside your body? The famous coronavirus is probably somewhere around here, too. Yes, that's right. But if you want to defeat your enemy, you have to know him. So, today we're going to talk about how viruses work, who they are, and why they haven't wiped us out so far. Let's start. We're going to try to explain everything using plain and simple terms. You don't need to know about nucleic acids, lymphocytes, chromosomes, etc. You'll probably learn all this in biology class. But until then, we can give you a general idea about these little buggers. To begin with, viruses can only be seen with an electron microscope. In comparison, take an ordinary bacterium. The human eye can't see it either, but a virus is 1,000 times smaller. Imagine that! Okay, we already established that there are millions of viruses inside the body. So what are they doing there? Let's see. The virus attaches itself to a certain cell. Each virus has its own favorite type. For example, hepatitis attaches to liver cells and the flu attaches to respiratory cells. Then the virus gets inside the cell and sort of dissolves inside it. It's kind of like when you add salt to water. It dissolves there and all the water becomes salty. It's like that, except the virus particles subjugate the cell and make it work for itself to create more versions of itself. After a few hours, instead of one virus, thousands of them are already inside the cell. In doing so, the cell dies and new viruses conquer and destroy more cells. In this way, one virus inside the organism can multiply to several millions or even billions in just one day. And in the process, it gradually kills the organism in which it is located. Come on, Tony, don't be like that. You've only learned half the information, and you've already decided that your life is over and you've been overcome by viruses. It's not like that. Our bodies are not that easy to defeat. Meet the one and only, the brave and invincible, the immune system. When a virus enters the body and starts destroying cells, the immune system immediately sets off its alarms. Special scouts are sent out to figure out what we are dealing with. But the virus is not stupid either. It hides inside the cells and attempts to deceive the defense in every possible way. However, in the end, it is found. When the enemy is identified, special killer cells are sent out to destroy both the infected cells and the virus itself. By the way, if the body encounters a virus it already knows, it has a special units just for it. These are known as antibodies. The purpose of vaccination is to create this special unit in your body to fight a certain virus, because it is much worse when a new virus or a new strain of a known virus enters the body. By the way, new strains of viruses appear all the time. These buggers are so basic that they don't need much time to change. All kinds of external influences contribute to this. Soil, water, air, chemical compounds, solar radiation, and many other things cause viruses to mutate. For example, the influenza virus originally only affected birds, but it quickly mutated and became dangerous to humans as well. So, when a new virus enters the body, the immune system does not see it at all, so the disease lasts longer and it is very painful. That's when the fever, runny nose, cough, and other symptoms show up. It is a natural defensive reaction. This way the body is trying to destroy and chase away the intruder. We can't recommend you to take any pills, as it is the job of professional doctors. But you can definitely help your immune system by drinking a lot of water. Not only toxins, but also bacteria and viruses are eliminated from the body along with water. Let's recap. There are a lot of viruses present in our body, and a whole bunch more around us. But our immune system is so cool that it fights them non-stop, so most of the time we feel fine. So, the most important rule in staying healthy is to help your immune system. Maintain hygiene. Wash your hands. Wash any fruits and vegetables thoroughly. Air the room. Wipe the dust and keep your house clean overall. The more viruses we wash away, air out, or destroy before they enter the body, the easier it will be for your inner guard. It's also important not to get too cold. Stay away from drafts and dress properly when the weather is cold. Otherwise, your immune system may weaken. Then the viruses inside will feel free to multiply. In simple terms, that's what getting sick means. Stay healthy, friends. and tell us in the comments what else you want to know about our very complex and mysterious world. We'll definitely make some new videos on the most popular topics. Leave a like if you've learned something new and subscribe so you won't miss any new episodes of Super Tony.